an entire new fleet of trains coming, a significant investment in rail infrastructure, which should lead to a reduction in disruption and delays. However, this cannot and must not be used as an argument against the rapid introduction of Delay Repay 15 on the Great Eastern Main Line. So, moving specifically on to Delay Repay 15. On the 13th of October 2016, we had some very welcome news from the Department for Transport. The Secretary of State for Transport announced an improved compensation scheme, Delay Repay 15. Now, under this scheme, passengers are able to claim 25% of the cost of a single fare ticket for delays of between 15 and 29 minutes. Now, this scheme would go a long way towards incentivising improved efficiencies within the franchise and compensating commuters for the inconvenience suffered as a result of delayed services. Now, Delay Repay 15 has already been rolled out on Thames Link, on Southern, on the Great Northern franchise, but not on the Great Eastern Main Line under Greater Anglia. As I know from my own train journeys between Colchester and Liverpool Street, the smallest delay to a daily commute can cause, over time, significant disruption to our professional lives, especially in the mornings, and in addition to significant inconveniences to our private lives in the evening. It can make the difference between being able to tuck your kids in to bed at night and not, and we shouldn't underestimate the importance of that. Ultimately, like most of my fellow rail users, I would rather the reliability of the service be vastly improved first, but I know my constituents would also welcome the introduction of improved compensation rights.
Would you answer that?
Yes, of course.
I thank the Honourable Member for giving way, congratulate him for securing this adjournment debate, and apologise for not being here at the start of his speech. But I absolutely agree with the whole campaign. I think it's absolutely brilliant, and our passengers deserve this. Would he agree with me that any compensation scheme needs also to be easy to use, and that Greater Anglia not only need to introduce Delay Repay 15, but also need to make the scheme that they have at the moment more user-friendly, so that when people try to claim compensation, they're not blocked from doing so?
Well, I thank the Honourable Member for that intervention, and I would also like to thank him for the role that he plays on the Great Eastern Main Line Task Force. I think one of the reasons the GEMEL Task Force has been so successful is all the MPs from our region have spoken together collectively with one voice, taking the politics out of the issue and focused on the main issues that are going to drive improvements on our line, and we work very closely together on that. On the specific point around Delay Repay, he makes a very good point. There is little point having a compensation scheme if it is so hard and difficult to operate and it isn't user-friendly that people don't use it. Now, of course, there are people that will not bother to do it or will just for whatever reason choose not to. Some indeed choose to make a charity donation instead. And I think the figure to date has been...
Sky Cinema light up your 2019 with an explosion of must-see movies all year long.
Ooh, here we go.
Good boy.
Light up your 2019 with all this and so much more on Sky Cinema. Sky Cinema light up your 2019 with an explosion of must-see movies
over 30 minutes or more, not the improved Delay Repay scheme for delays of 15 minutes or more. Now, I can assure you, Madam Deputy Speaker, it is quite incredible how many journeys
to speak in this debate, adjournment debate, to give my extraordinarily strong support, the Member of Parliament for Colchester and for colleagues from across the East of England, for the campaign to improve the delay repay compensation for the users of the Great Eastern Main Line, and specifically to ask the Minister to introduce a 15-minute delay repay scheme. The price of a season ticket from Chelmsford to London is now £5,168. People are paying a huge amount of money to travel on our trains, and when the trains are delayed or fail to show up, people should be compensated. We must hold the train operators to account. Other parts of the country offer 15-minute delay repay services to commuters and to rail customers. And we, our rail users in Essex, Suffolk, through East Anglia, should not be treated as second-class passengers. This is not the first time I've raised the issue of delay repay in this House. In fact, according to Hansard, I've raised it four times in ministerial questions, including, I remember, Madam Deputy Speaker, once running into the House on the train station because my train from Chelmsford had been so delayed that morning. I only just got in time to ask the question. The Secretary of State has said on the floor of the House that he hopes that delay repay will be introduced this year, and I hope that the Minister tonight will be able to give further reassurance. In Chelmsford, my constituents have seen continual delays and cancellations, especially over the past 12 months. They've also seen situations where trains which were promised to be 12 carriages long then turn out to be only 8 or only 4. Chelmsford Railway Station is the busiest two-platform station anywhere in the country. And when trains are shortened or cancelled, the train station becomes incredibly overcrowded very quickly. Passengers then are put in danger themselves, and sometimes they can't then get on to the next train. So even though they turned up, they hoped to get the train, in theory was leaving on time, but they simply couldn't. Service that they're getting.
Welcome to Sky VIP, your loyalty program. Welcome to Sky VIP, your loyalty program that gets better the longer you're with us. It's free to join, and you get access to loads of tickets, experiences, tech, and more. As a Silver VIP, you can be part of exclusive experiences and immerse yourself in Sky VR. In the Gold tier, you also get free fibre setup and SkyGo Extra, so you can watch on the go even if you're not online. With Platinum, you get all this plus rewards on Sky Mobile and Sky Q. And Diamond VIPs skip the queue to speak to our help team and enjoy entertainment at its best with exclusive discounts on the Sky Soundbox. And that's just the start. There's a welcome gift waiting for you when you join. It's our way of saying thank you. Aww. Join now for free in the MySky app.
Excellent. To get that second railway station built in Chelmsford, not just for the people of Chelmsford themselves,
that point, as you reference, of course, the Bewley Park station, not just important for Chelmsford, but for the whole Great Eastern Main Line, because it affords us the opportunity to create two passing loops. Increase capacity hugely on our line.
Absolutely, and thank you for making that point so very clearly. So overcrowded train line that goes across the whole of the east of England, to be able to have more capacity so that stopping trains can be overtaken by the fast trains will help the people of Colchester, they'll help the people who then travel on from Colchester to areas such as Clacton and the stations in between, they'll help the people of Norwich, the people of Ipswich, because their trains will be able to overtake at that key point. It gets you not only a train station, but also a passing loop. You're getting two bits of infrastructure for the price of one, Rail Minister. We really must bring this on board. We have waited for many, many months.
Be back. Open Spotify.
Is the last station on a branch line. And whilst the debate is quite rightly about the
if you're seeing a no satellite signal message on your Sky Q box,
lie on repayment or compensation for delayed services. What they really want is regular, reliable services. We understand, all of us that use the railway line understand that as a branch line service, we have a limited number of trains at our disposal, typically about a train an hour. And it is therefore so very, very important that reliability is at the forefront of the train operating company's priorities. Because, Madam Deputy Speaker, if a train is delayed or cancelled, then my constituents are presented with a tough choice. Do they find some means of transporting themselves to Witham, which is where the branch line joins the main line, or to Chelmsford to get the availability of car parking spaces to come into town, or do they ring in to work and make their apologies and excuses. And that's not a decision that anyone would wish to have forced upon them as regularly as my constituents find it. What they want is to know that when they turn up at the station, that the train that's meant to depart at a